Yeah, well, this is really awkward, Foos.
But I'm back.
Hey there, Foos. Mr. T here with your Pretendo Direct. Now, this Direct will be a little bit different than the ones I normally do because there are some fools on this channel named Big T who finally reveals himself, and he kind of, you know, went over all the different E3 conferences himself, and you know, kind of let you fools know where pretty much me and him stood. So me being his alter ego, we have pretty much the similar thoughts. So what we're gonna do today here is just kind of talk about some of the frustrations, if you will, some of the shall I say, disappointment that some of us had with the Direct, and to let you fools know where we stand and what we think about Nintendo going forward through this year and in the future. So let's go ahead and begin that. So anyway, like I was saying, or should I say, like Big T was saying, the Direct was a bit of a disappointment. There weren't really any surprises outside of Diamond Cross Machinima. Or excuse me, I messed that up. Diamond Cross Machina. Diamond Cross Machinima. Diamond Cross Machina. That's it. Diamond Cross Machina. Outside of that game, which looked fantastic, I should say, right up my alley. I love science fiction. I love mechs. And this game is looking really good. I'm a big fan of Xenoblade Chronicles X. It's one of the reasons I love that game so much is because of the whole mech thing. I just couldn't wait to get my mech in the game, even though I had to wait quite a few hours to get that. But when I finally got it, I really was able to really dig into the game and really enjoy it. So speaking of digging into, this is our deep dive into frustrations and, like I said, disappointments. Started off really strong. I figured, hey, they're going to show this game out here out of the gate, which was definitely a surprise. He's like, oh, you're thinking many surprises might show up based on the fact that they showed this game first, that they might have some surprises up their sleeves after all, which was very exciting. Then we started to get other games announced, like Super Mario Party, which was a delight because it was good to see a new Mario Party. There was some worry about the online, but as of now, we know that there will be some online modes, which is cool. That game needs those online modes in these days, so that's a cool thing. And it was very good to see that. You know, initially, we were still a little bit apprehensive because of the previous Mario Party game, but it was good to see that this game is going to be, you know, kind of back to form when it comes to Mario Party games. So that's a cool thing. And, you know, they just showed some of the games. Fortnite got an announcement, obviously. They talked about DLC for Xenoblade Chronicles 2, which looks fantastic. It's basically a whole new damn game, which is amazing to see that. I haven't even finished Xenoblade Chronicles 2 yet, so as excited I am for the DLC, I just need to finish the damn game first. that was cool to see. You got Starlink Battle for Atlas, I believe it's called, and then you got some Star Fox in there, which was very cool also to see. Would have liked to have seen a Star Fox game, but this is the closest we're going to get, at least this year anyway. So at least there is some Star Fox love still out there, because people are worried that the after Zero and the terrible sales of that Star Fox might be in trouble. So it was good to see some Star Fox love there. We also got kind of quick reel, demo reel of what's coming. We got some third-party games announced. We got Dragon Ball FighterZ, which was cool to see. It was speculated on that game coming, but we weren't sure, so it was good to see that. Although it was pretty quick that they showed the game, you thought there would be a little bit bigger of an announcement, but no, it wasn't. You know, you get other little third-party games announced, nothing major or anything like that. People were expecting to see major things like and stuff like that. Nah, but not because of leaks, but you just suspect the Switch doing strong, and it's year two. We're in here, and you thought maybe you'll see some unexpected things coming. And we got, like I said, the mech game from Marvelous, but outside of that, no real surprises. We did get to see the new Fire Emblem game. I believe it's called The Three Houses, which is very cool, and looks great. It looks beautiful. I think Big T forgot to talk about that in his initial video, so I'm going to talk about that now. The game looks phenomenal. Beautiful to see. A big strategy RPG done right on a console. Looks great. I can't wait to get my hands on that game. But I guess that was a surprise, because the surprise was the game is actually not coming this year. So that was the kind of surprise you didn't want. And although I'm not too worried about it, I'm fine with the game being delayed. There was a lot of stuff coming this year, and I've been buying a pretty good amount of games lately. And throughout this month is going to be pretty crazy for me as far as purchasing games. It was still the kind of surprise you didn't want. You wanted a surprise of something new. But like I said, no big deal at the end of the day. But we was expecting to have that game this year. But c'est la vie. And that was pretty much the major stuff I can think of. I'm missing here something here or there. And then we got basically the Smash Brothers Ultimate Direct. We got it. Obviously, it was called Smash Brothers Ultimate, which is cool. All the characters from all Smash games are coming into this game. Great. New character models, new move sets. The game looks phenomenal. What can I say? Looks really good. It was good to see the love and care put into this game. And boy, they give us a lot of love and care, because, like I said, the E3 Direct basically became the Smash Ultimate Direct at that point. So we got 25-ish minutes or so of Smash, and that really just kind of brought things to a halt. Like, that was another game that we were expecting to see, obviously, so it wasn't a surprise. I guess for some that it was a surprise that it wasn't Smash 4 Ultimate, or Smash 4 Deluxe, I should say. But in some ways, it kind of is, because they're bringing the 3DS stages over from Super Smash Brothers for 3DS. So that's a cool thing. But, you know, this game is built ground up for the Switch, and you can tell. You just got to look at it. It don't take too much time. And so a lot of fools were just saying that, you know, they spent so much time on this game because they wanted to make sure fools knew that this wasn't just some kind of port of the Wii U game. And I knew that before this event happened, that it wasn't going to be a port, because I figured Nintendo would have said that already. They aren't shy about talking about Wii U ports ahead of time. So why surprise us in a bad way, a negative way at least? I thought it would have been negative to make people think that, oh, this is going to be a new Smash, and then all of a sudden it's a Smash port. But, you know, some fools still think it's a port. I mean, what can you do about that? And some people said, you know, they spent so much time on it to let people know that this wasn't a port. And they spent all that time, and guess what? The fools still think it was a port. I mean, that's just what's going to happen. Some people are just haters, but some people just don't believe that it's a new Smash game. And so it didn't matter if you spent 2 hours in the Direct on Smash. People would have still came out thinking, oh, it's just a port, because, you know, there's not much you could do coming from 1080p 60 frames per second to 1080p 60 frames per second. I mean, that's just not a whole lot of difference you can do initially. If you really look at it, I mean, it doesn't take that much to look at it and just tell that this is a different game. But some people were just going to believe that because you're going from HD to HD. So that wasn't going to be a big leap for anybody, and that's just the way it was. It's not too different than, I don't know, like early Xbox One games compared to late Xbox 360 games. There wasn't a whole lot of wow factor there, you know? So outside of a couple of games, it wasn't like, whoa, I gotta go out and buy this thing right now. You know, that was just going to be the case. So when people say, you know, they had to prove that this wasn't a port, at the end of the day, it wasn't going to matter. People were going to think what they were going to think. So why destroy the pacing and, you know, whatnot of the E3 Direct by doing that. So basically, you know, the Direct was okay. It was just the fact that it was just a regular Direct. And some will say, well, you know, Nintendo hasn't cared that much about E3 for a long time, and a lot of companies haven't. And, you know, that just might be the case, and that might be true. And, you know, being that the fact they didn't have any blow-away games that they hadn't already announced at this point, you know, they had the Let's Go Pikachu, Let's Go Eevee game already announced beforehand, and we knew that Smash was coming beforehand, so they didn't really have any wow surprises outside of the early 2019 game, which is the Daemon Cross Machina game. So that's why they showed that, and that was pretty much all they had. You know, that is, you know, like I said, the Direct wasn't bad. It just was not well-paced because of Nintendo feeling like they had to spend so much time on Smash to explain that this was a new Smash. So, you know, that's just how it is. It is what it is. But the thing is, people, I bet some people got mad, or people are upset, or thinking that the Switch is dead now, or all this nonsense. I'm like, the Switch has way more third-party support this year than it had last year, and I'm sure that's going to continue next year. Buying a lot of games. I've been buying a lot of games for my Switch lately, from the eShop to, you know, retail games coming out, and there's some good stuff coming out in the next couple weeks. I mean, we got Project Octopath coming. I'm getting Eve's 8. I'm getting Wolfenstein 2. Like, there's games, fools. I'm pretty happy with what's coming. And we just got Fortnite, which is very cool. Native voice chat done on the Switch. What a surprise, fool. Wow, surprise. It was funny because a lot of fools were like, oh, the Switch ain't powerful enough to do native voice chat. It's not strong enough. And I was like, that's the dumbest thing I ever heard, because I have native voice chat on my Nintendo DS. Not 3DS, my Nintendo DS has native voice chat. So that was just the dumbest thing I ever heard. I don't know why people would ever believe that, but, you know, people just say the craziest things off the wall when it comes to, oh, what the Switch can and can't do based on the power that they believe in themselves, with their armchair analyst abilities of knowing tech inside of their own brains, that the Switch can't and can't do certain things. But, you know, I think Panic Button has proven that the Switch can run current-gen games, obviously with some stipulations, but running current-gen games and looking good with Wolfenstein 2, Doom, and whatnot. So, I just, you know, this is kind of weird. That is what it is. But, you know, like I said, Nintendo obviously has a different take on what's going on with E3, and seems like other companies are following suit, because E3 all around wasn't that stellar to me. There was some good, you know, there's some good shows, like I said, but it was nothing like, whoa, mind-blowing, crazy, just blew me away. I gotta have this new game, I gotta have this new console, nothing like that. And so it was just kind of underwhelming across the board, and it's just that Nintendo happened to be the last show, and they didn't really deliver on any big surprises or any major crazy surprises. So, you know, that's all there is to it. But like I said, Switch is doing fine. It's going to continue to sell. It's going to sell crazy based on just what it's already doing. And, you know, getting these ports, like I said, getting these day and date third party games, like I said. And also, you know, with with Let's Go Pikachu, Let's Go Eevee, those games are gonna sell stellar. Might be the most highest selling games in a Pokemon franchise. You never know. I feel like it might be. And obviously Smash is gonna smash and sell. So it's like the Switch is doing well, it's gonna continue to do well. And there's still some surprises coming. I believe Panic Button recently announced that next month they're gonna talk about a major title that they're porting to the Switch. So it's going to continue. This trend is going to continue to ride along with the Switch is selling, which it is. And that install base is just climbing and climbing. It's going to be great, fools. So there's nothing really to worry about. I don't know what these fools is talking about. But anyway, like I said, everything looking good. So, yeah, fools, just calm down with all that nonsense. The doom and gloom. It's always this doom and gloom with these Nintendo fools. I don't know. And the Nintendo haters, obviously, they go do the doom and gloom. But it is what it is. I'm enjoying my Switch. I was just, you know, disappointed in the show of E3. Not what I'm getting on my Switch and what's being delivered. So just to clarify that, fools, it's going to be great year for the Switch. Yeah, the first party output isn't as strong as last year, but just think about next year. Oh my gosh, just think about it. It's going to be crazy. And the Switch is doing well. It's going to continue to do well. So let me know what you fools think in the comments below. Like I said, there's nothing to worry about. There's no doom and gloom to worry about. Switch is doing fantastic. Great stuff still coming from first party and third party. So I'm looking forward to that, fools. Let me know what you think. Like always, thank you for watching and listening. And I'll see you, fools, next time. Peace out.